Hello, I'm Kyle Cannon, Operations Section Chief for Pacific Northwest Team 2, with your operational update for October 6th, 2020. So starting on the north side of the fire, up around Highway 36 in the Hidden Valley, the dozer line that ties North Butte area down to the South Fork of the Trinity River is holding well. We did have an additional spot yesterday, no extra spots overnight, and things are holding well in there. We're doing mop up and securing that line. Moving around to the west from DP 113 on Highway 36 down to the Mad River. We did have a 50-acre spot that grew in there yesterday. We punched a dozer line down to the Mad River Road, did some burning last night, and we'll continue with that burning today to remove those unburned fuels between our control line and the main fire. Moving to the west down on the southwest side of Ruth Lake, we've tied in with hand crews from DP 109 on the Van Dusen Road, working our way to the east, direct along the fire's edge towards Ruth Lake, another couple of days, and we'll have that tied in as well. There's also some good work being done on the west side of the Van Dusen Road. There's some unburned fuel in this little corner that we're working on, bringing the fire down to the Van Dusen as well as down to the dozer line in that area. Moving around to the west side of the fire, we do have fire that's actively moving to the north and to the west, so we're utilizing firing operations to remove the unburned fuel between our control line here and the main fire up towards Coffee Pot. Moving to the south, we also have that same type of operation going on around Little Round Mountain Country, moving our way to the south, trying to remove that unburned fuel and tie in that southwest corner of the fire. So moving to the south zone of the August complex, down around Covelo, just to the east of Covelo, there is still a piece of indirect line that needs to be burned out, similar to what we're doing on the north side. Working with CAL FIRE resources, we're going to bring fire down along our control line and work our way back into the main fire to try to tie off that piece, remove the unburned fuel, and secure that area, and that will be going on today as well. As I mentioned, in summary, there's a number of ignition operations, firing operations that are happening across the fire today. The purpose of that, again, is to remove the unburned fuel between our control lines and the main fire. By removing that fuel, it greatly reduces the chances of the fire crossing our control lines and greatly increases the effectiveness of that control line.